Numero 24, Filippo Lavorenzi. Numero Hello and a very good evening from the Stadio Manigo in Treviso, where tonight we have the climax to Pool B in the Under 26 Nations Summer Series. At the top of the table clash is Italy and Wales fighting out what really is a winner-takes-all match. The prize is a place in the playoff final against South Africa next Tuesday evening. Both sides come into this one in very good form, having beaten Scotland and the vast improving Georgian side. These two sides last met only a couple of months ago in Wales, and it was the Italians that left with an away victory. So will we see revenge for Brian Haywood and his team? We will find out in just over 80 minutes from now. But before we get underway tonight with the anthems, we'll take a moment to stand against racism and show that it has no place in rugby or in our society. As well as standing in solidarity against the Russian invasion of Ukraine, our thoughts are very much with the families affected in Ukraine at this time. Just about set here in Treviso. It'll be hard pushed to find better. Marcel Anthony and those two. The teams when we get going. And after that gutsy win against Georgia, Byron Haywood has made just two changes to his side. They both come in the pack. for the Pickler. If Daniel gets his chance to shine, Ben Williams earns his first start after impressing against Georgia. Ryan Woodman will wear the 8 jersey as he spearheads the pack. The classy Joe Hawkins will captain the side from inside centre. As for Italy, they have lost their captain, Ross Vincent, with a calf injury. So second row, Alessandro Ortambina will step up and lead the Italians. It's a new Italian centre pairing for this one, Dewey Passarella, 12, and Clermont point, Francois May, outside centre. Zebras, Lornel Pani will once again start at full-back for Italy. A quick look at the replacements. Watch out for Wales's Morgan Morse. He is only 17 and may still be a schoolboy, but he really is a real talent. Mehmet Rousselet is the man in the middle for this final Pro B clash. Dan Edwards to get us underway. It's a fine take from Marini. QG sets his pack, but Wales don't let him settle. And what a counter that is. Where is that ball? It's in a red jersey. It's Harry Houston. Will act at 9. He leaves it for his big prop in Nathan Evans. It's Morgan Lloyd gets back up. Wales just happy to take it through the phases early on. Tunza standing his neck receiver. It's not going to be him. It's going to be Evans on the short line. Still there for Lloyd and his troops. As Reece Barrett gets his first touch. And there's a knock on from the captain, Joe Hawkins. What a counter that was. Byron Herod and his team straight from the first phase, showing their intent right from the off. It's well taken in, and the gap opened.
It's here.
Chris Tunza said thank you very much and went straight through. The extra chief, 20-year-old. Of course, he's already been capped at senior level. So highly rated in Wales. He's back down with the under-20s. Already showing what he's all about. Let's go! Running behind, running crowd in front of their home fans. As the sun shines, let's hope for some attacking rugby. Plenty last night. First things first is to get this scrum sorted and get the ball away.
Yeah, I understand.
Okay. Of course, the last time these two sides met was in Wales in the Six Nations. Italy leaving triumphant that day. So it will be a bit of revenge. Wales will want.
Fresh! Five!
Andre Kogi. He's not going to get a chance to put that in as Wales win the first penalty of the match from the scrum. What will they decide to do? Straight away, Joe Hawkins points to the sticks. A man that's led, by example, all tournament for Wales. He's going to try against Georgia. In all 5 games in the recent Six Nations. He's got so much experience at this level. Played in last year's competition as well in Cardiff. And the year before that, just 17. Some talent. Hawkins to get the first points of the match. And he does indeed. Joe Hawkins, so first blood to Wales. Few happy fans out there, 3-0. They go in front. Giovanni Sante. It's his first touch. Hawkins is there on the receiving end. It's David Jenkins. Another Exeter Chiefs. Takes it up as the Caterpillar is set. Morgan Lloyd goes long. It's a good touch from Morgan Lloyd. It's up towards the halfway line. Dragons man. There's a bit of rugby at Ebbie Vale too. A great battle with him and Shea Hope for this nine jersey. Fortunately, Hope has been injured, so Lloyd gets his chance. It's Frangini. Has it at the back. And this blue rumbling maul has been so good in the pool so far. He's broken off. And Kobe looks right but goes left. There's another error. Chance maybe for Wales to attack. Edwards uses Hawkins. And here they go. Fine ball from Grady. What a step that is from Harry Houston. Nice hands and the line comes, but it's spilled. And Coogee picks it up. It's a bit helter-skelter from both teams. Giovanni Santi says enough's enough, I'll take it to ground. Pani stepping up into first receiver. Again, the ball finds the deck. We're going to come back. The referee has awarded Italy a scrum. That's exactly what Edwards will be looking. His big forwards outside him in space. If he can get that all evening, Wales will have a great shot of winning this game.
Let's go, guys, please.
Italy won three of their last six matches against Wales. Before that, they lost 13 in a row. All their victories have come away from home, though. Lost seven encounters in their own back garden, so they'll want to change that. Massimo Brunello and his team.
I want more space, okay? Not pre-engage, okay? Please.
A word with both front rows. Genovese, Frangini and Bartoloni. It's Evans, Daniel and Barrett.
Yeah.
All pretty big boys. In that front row.
Crash! Bind!
So, attacking platform right pretty much in the centre of the pitch, but that scrum's gone down again. There, David Jenkins is getting his team roaring at his front three. Student at the University of Exeter, he won the Bucks final. He scored a late try to beat Durham. So a bit of silverware already. For the second row.
Crash!
He's highly rated and thought of by Rob Baxter. In the professional ranks as well as the university ranks.
More space. It's the last time. More space. He's still moving the pitch for the green guy. Let's go.
So take three.
Yes, second. Crash.
Let's hope it's a good one.
Mine. Set.
And this time it is. It's a good shunt. An Italian pack. Hughie and Santi. And Italy are on the front foot. And here's their winger, Cuminetti. He's bundled into touch.
Number three.
A bit of afters there from Mason Grady.
Number three.
Francois May. Looking back for the Italy penalty. Cuminetti, he was well taken down by Ollie Andrew.
It's number one, Benny.
Penalty coming on Reece Barrett's side. As Pani goes long, and what a kick that is from the fullback. The man who moved from Benetton to Zebre just a couple of months ago. Had a good few games in the URC towards the end of the season, getting a try for Connacht. So Frangini goes to the front and he gets it back. And Italy are on the charge through Passarella. Are they over that line? They're so close. Referee, he's just going to have a look at this.
Time off, please.
Some line.
Go ahead, Benny.
By the Italian centre.
No decision about the grounding.
He came from nowhere.
Can you tell me if there is try or not?
Did Passarella. Okay, and there's bodies everywhere. And they're just going to look where it was grounded. If so, and when.
Not now, please.
Plenty of bodies. Who's actually got the final one?
Yeah.
The ball is clearly short of the line.
Okay. So we restart the game for a scrum blue at 5 meters.
Correct.
Okay. No. Scrum blue.
So it'll be a restart with a scrum. They were close, but not close enough, as you can see from your pictures. That just shows the threat they can offer. I think Wales thought they would keep it in tight. Frangini used something slightly different.
No, it's not too big. Please.
They're still here, are the Italians.
No, on the line, please. Yeah, second.
Kobe just throwing the ball up there at nine. Looking, assessing his options. The option comes in a free kick. I'd say they'll go again. That's exactly Riccardo Genovese.
I want more space.
Big Italian prop says he wants.
Let's go, mate.
Plays for Torino. They actually were promoted to the top 10 after beating Rugby Union Catalonia a month ago. So moving up out of Serie A into the top 10 again. RCS Torino.
Bye.
Set. Penalty once more. Moves away. The so-called home team. Zoltan Bina just taps the referee.
Yeah, please.
Says yes once more.
Number one. knee on the ground, and number three, he fall on the ground. Yeah. Let's go. Back, please. So back. It's the last time, okay?
Last time, says the referee. So he wants
crush.
Much better performance from both teams at the scrum. Don't we all? Go straight down once more.
You must to keep height, okay? I want elbow high and a long bind, okay? Please.
Cardiff's Reese Barrett, Carlo Genovese, the two men pulled. Good man for a bit of loose play is Reese Barrett, very good with ball in hand. Now he's stuck in. It's daytime job in the nitty gritty here.
Crush. Five. Step.
And again, a penalty. And the referee has had enough. And he gives the yellow card. And Wales are down to 14. And Nathan Evans will walk off. He can't believe it.
Time off.
So Wales will have to sort this out as they lose one of their front row forwards.
18. Okay.
It was three penalties and then he branded the yellow.
And who goes? Six.
Had them well warned.
Six.
Looks like Ben Williams is going to be sacrificed.
Yeah.
In the back row.
Let's go. Okay, let's go.
Sure what the weight is at the moment. Now Adam Williams does come on. So his first job will be to hang in there, try his best, put this up deadly in the front row. It's actually not Williams, it's actually Ollie Andrew. So a late call from Wales. Ollie Andrew is the man to come off.
Crush.
So 15 against 14.
Stay high.
Free pretty much telling him to stay high. Ball's in. Told to use it as Coogie. Nitley go out the back. Panny comes in short. Good scrambling from Wales. Hughie. And the hands. And Italy are in the corner. And Sir inside centre, Dewey Passarella. The first try of the evening, the Italians. The fans are delighted. It was coming, the pressure at the scrum. Passarella in the corner with a fine finish. Well worked in the end. From this blue machine. Coogie at nine. Great hands. Passarella. Didn't have much to do, but what he did, it was perfect.
Oh, good, Benny.
Thanks.
Great distribution. And the yellow boots of Passarella. Touching the ball down. So Giovanni Santi, his first kick of the night, right in the corner. Sweetly struck, has it hung on, just clipped the post and bounces out. But Italy, they'll be happy. Well worked, well oiled machine from the scrum. Plays his club rugby for Ruggers Treviso. Very close to this ground, so pretty much on his home paddock. He gets over the line. Well in, and Wales are on the counter. It's big Adam Williams pouncing in that ball. Can Wales hit back? Ryan Woodman getting over the gain line. They may have numbers outside Wales. In the end, it's just Jenkins on his own. Woodman goes again. They have the advantage. Lloyd Hawkins, what a ball that is. Bouncing pass to Harry Houston and the dancing feet. He's a slippery eel, is Harry Houston. Chunza, he's a hard man to stop. Lloyd once more. Wales going through the hands. Hawkins goes himself. He's got a second row. He's hanging out in the wing. It's David Jenkins. Had to stop, did Reece Barrett, but he checked and did well. Williams on the barnstorming run. Tunes it once more. Bit of a decoy and gets it on to his teammate and Jenkins. Italy in with the hands all over that ball. The penalty will come.
Okay. Captain. Option.
Hawkins will have the option here. Of post, or will he go to the corner?
Yeah. Offside and not rolling away.
But. And again, he opts for the easy 3 points.
19 minutes.
You see the rerun of the Italian try.
19.
Well put away was Passarella.
60, Benny.
Yeah. I know,
not
yet,
but next one.
Nothing.
It's
just
now. Hawkins. Played 7 times for the Ospreys this season. 6 in the ERC, 1 in Europe. He's very well liked. Went to Liberty. He's well liked here as he keeps kicking 3 points. And we'll have our first water break. Wales in front. Just a single point. Huddle. Wales have won their last 2 matches. Aiming to win this tonight. Winning 3 in a row for the first time since 2016, when they completed an under 20 Six Nations Grand Slam. That was some year. Jason Streams, the coach, ex-Bristol Newport player, Owen Watkin, Adam Baird. Owen Phillips captained that team. Keelan Giles was involved. We want to get back there. Do Wales. Certainly trying to build something. Catching the likes of England and Ireland. It's Panny. Gets it over the top. Slow ball. Well moved. Matuli. Nidley have a few spare numbers, of course, with the extra man. Neil's coming in and shooting the line. Well defended. Was Dan Edwards. Again, big tackling. In that sea of red. Not letting Italy settle. It's Passarella. Last act at nine. Santi. Here's May. He is quick. He'll go short side. Nazarene. Offers himself up. Genovese next up in front. Something different from Santi. That is lovely from the number 10. Well covered by Cameron Winnett. See plenty of an attack in the first couple of games. Not quite yet. This is opposite man. Looks for the return kick. He looks confused, but his team, I think, were in front. But there was a bit of obstruction. And Wales will have a get out of jail penalty. As the clock kicks down, two Wales get back to their full complement of players. Another couple of minutes.
I don't know.
Three minutes on the yellow, Benny.
How many?
Three.
On this very ground, of course, a couple of months ago, Italy beat England for the first time ever at under 20 level.
Just a question.
Some evening.
Yeah.
So when
for the Azzurri this year, they won three games in the Six Nations.
You can't go out.
Finished fourth.
So you must stay.
Yeah. The likes of Alessandro Garbisi there at the time. Now, of course, getting his first cap at the fully fledged international level. Just last week, scoring a try as well. Alongside his brother Paolo. Some talent in the Garbisi family. Daniel. Woodman, well taken off the top. Here's Hawkins. Uses the battering ram in Grady. Somehow comes back to the captain. Lloyd. And the no-look pass. It's probably a bit too cool at the moment. Just want to settle it down. There's Dan Edwards. It's back with the Italian number 9. Kyogi. Some fine touch. He finds Winnett. And he steps. He's brought down. Here's Barrett. Meets far. With Frangini. Morgan Lloyd. And Edwards. Chinza. Looks up. Goes route one. Daniel. Ponders. And he says, follow me, men. Williams. Hawkins. To Mason Grady. Lazarine. Was ever so well. Chunza. Always looking for the offload. Report. David Jenkins. Pani plucked that out of the air. And Italy, if that had been a better pass, May could have been away. Maureen does well in the number 9. Cougar finds a bit of grass. Ben Williams needs a bit of help. The ball's gone loose. In the end, Wales do scramble back. But Italy, plenty of pressure. Get another penalty, holding on. Smart play from Andrea Kugi. If the control had been a little bit better, it could have been a second try for the Italians. Nathan Evans, very close to getting back on this pitch. His teammates will want that sooner rather than later.
Wait.
Here he comes. Man, he's just moved to the Dragons. From Cardiff.
Okay. Captain.
Scrum. He'll be straight in the thick of it. Left 10 minutes ago from a scrum. Oh, he's back at it. In the hot heat of the battle.
Let's go. Here. Let's go. Seconds, crash. Bye.
So, what will he do? We've seen the threat from Passarella and May in the middle of the park. We've also seen the threat of the eight man right at this scrum. So threats are all over the park.
Don't forget the breakfast. Okay, let's go.
Just be deciding which option is best from the number nine.
Number two, please. Let's go. Let's go, Red, please.
As Adam Williams comes back, takes his place back in the bench. So there's a good chance we'll see him later on in this match. In this heat, there'll be a few tired men in that front row. Is in there somewhere. Kugi goes himself, and Santi. They go out the back, and the line comes, and it's the fullback, Lorenzo Pani. He cut them up, did the zebra fullback. Italy get their second score. That's their danger man, Lorenzo Pani. Santi to May and the flat ball. Pani just went straight through like a knife through butter. He was flat and he was dangerous and he was fierce and he scored. Giovanni Santi. That's the extras this time. 12-6. You can see they get some quick ball and they're Packer on top. The Red Sea parted. And Pani coasted through it. Good at the mall from Wales. Every time Italy seem to score, Wales do win the infringement from the kickoff. Both these sides are the top try scorers in this year's under 27 summer series, 11 each. Wales obviously yet to get on the score sheet over the try line so far. We will expect tries. History in this competition in the opening games is the go by. You see, the game is boiling. It is getting there in this opening half an hour. And still only trail by six. You can see there, they've had their lion's share of possession.
Let's go, boys, please.
Let's go, Nick.
This area here, the scrum, will be Sean Connors, Craig Everett, and Byron Edwards' main responsibility. It stays like this, no doubt at half time. There will be plenty of words spoken to sort this out.
Come, please. Three and one. If you don't say it high, you go out. It's clear? Is it clear? Out.
If you don't stay high, you'll go out. So again, the warning is there. We've seen one yellow. Hopefully that's enough.
Let's go.
Wales always seem to travel well. Plenty of jerseys in the crowd. Of course, ahead to the Football World Cup in a couple of months' time.
Crush!
See fans everywhere, football or rugby. They will travel. And this time goes the way of Wales. And that'll be a real confidence booster. Nathan Evans. He's probably the happiest man in the park right now. The fans are getting stuck in too. As Edwards pokes that deep into the Italian 22. Bartoloni penalised. Getting a bit on his own medicine after being on top in this opening exchange. Ooh, Daniel. They go off the top. And Lloyd. And here's Hawkins. Number 12 picks his angles and he goes. And Williams makes the hard yards. And they have the advantage. Shinza. Great brace of strength. Frackful. And Barrett. They're edging closer. Evans there. But he leaves it. As Woodman goes next. Ball just skips out. Bit of protection needed from Morgan Lloyd. Hawkins fired out back inside to the fullback. Can Wales get in? I think they can. That'll be a smashing try. They just have to hold their breath. Harry Houston just looking there. He thinks he got that down. Referee,
his
officials say no. It's a great exchange from Winnett and Houston. Oh my goodness, is that not a cracking finish?
Captain! Captain!
He's still asking a few questions. The referee says no. Junza goes himself. the big drive from the second row. And one more is needed, and there it is. And Wales do get their first try of the night. And a good time to score it. Nathan Evans spent a bit of time in the sin bin. And he's back and he's fighting and he's scoring tries. Chunza, a powerful endeavour carry. And then on his shoulder was Nathan Evans. And he wasn't going to be stopped. Look at him. Pouncing and prowling. Gets tight and low. And the Italian defensive line was broken. Hawkins. That's the simple extras. And Wales are in front, 13 points to 12. So it's to and fro with the scoreline at the moment. Big extra second row on the charge. His front row teammate. A bit of a gift. His teammates were around him. And the leg drive was so, so good. The referee raises the hand. Wales doing the grunt and scoring. So, two tries to one. As Ricardo Bartoloni comes from the field. Luca Rizzoli makes an early entrance. Union Rugby Catalonian player. Based in Serie A or Catalonia. League underneath the top 10. Morgan Lloyd finds the safety of the touch. His brother Evan, played in the under 20s himself, bit of history in the family of rugby. Santi uses his forwards. And here it is back with the number 10. Cuts it out. Passarella proving to be a bit of a nuisance for Wales. Mataloni, he's hammered back. Ricardo Genovese. Fugio, he's not going to get much time at nine to wait about. He has to get stuck in. Is trying to get their hands in there. Reese Barrett as well, but it's back to the Italians. Trey Cooey back up and in his normal position. It's Genovese. A couple of carries from him now. Santi and Pani out the back door. That's absolutely beautiful from the fullback. Wales so unlucky. I'm sure the turnover was there. Here's the replacement, Rizzoli. Patient build up. Frangini.
Advantage for Nocon.
Well back.
And where's the advantage?
From the Welshman. Seems to be hands in there.
You don't leave the ball, number two.
It was. Meffin Daniel. Italy will have the opportunity for a shot at goal. It's all a wee bit loose and ready there. Wales defence looked pretty strong. Finally broke. Santi. He'll put his side back in front. Sacks the upright. That was an Italian fly half. 15-13. As the cheers ring loud and clear at the Stadio Maningo. It's Marini. Stretches his legs. Sure, that ball is back on their side. This time, Wales too eager. Here's the try score. Nathan Evans is pushed back.
Number three.
A couple of Italian players giving him his marching orders.
I have a face left by 17 blue. He's taunted the opposition. 17 blue.
It's a penalty?
Yes. So
it looks like Luca Rizzoli is going to be penalised. This is a good gift for Wales. Byron Haywood and his team.
The player checks the hand of the player red, so I turn the decision.
Reversing the decision.
Please, you must keep calm, okay?
Wordsworth, he was taunting. Nathan Evans.
17. Stop.
It's the referee, to be fair to him, he's not standing for anything. Neither are his teammates and his officials.
Ball, please. Yeah. I don't see.
It's the man from Port Talbot, Dan Edwards, asks for a ball. Is rugby for Aberferyon, Young Player of the Year this season, and Most Improved Player. Learning a lot from Alec Thomas, the former Scarlet Gloucester, Gwent Wales Sevens player. Also works a lot with James Hook. So he's working with the best anyway. So he's ready to have a big future. It's Daniel. And that's neat from Wales. And that's great set piece work. And they're edging closer. Started from David Jenkins. Where is the white ball? Some digging from Morgan Lloyd. On his knees there. He's back up. As the offload comes from Barrett. Lloyd again. To his fly half. Dan Edwards puts it in the air. What happened there? Is there a bit of obstruction on Ollie Andrew? He's smiling anyway.
Listen to me, keep your calm.
What a time this would be for Wales to get their second score.
Many times, so you must improve your discipline near the goal line. Okay? The more is good. No. Not really. Offside.
Wales just before half time. Really itching closer to this Italian try line. But again, we're going to have a TMO check.
Yes, I think we need to check. Yes.
Just waiting here. Both sides in anticipation.
Now,
here we go. Pani. Ollie Andrew. Doesn't look great. Lorenzo Pani. He's looking straight at the winger. Where's that arm as well? Big calls to be made just before half time.
Okay. The blue player, don't try to cut the ball. You go direct to the 14 ring.
Yes. That. Yes.
Okay. Is there trying opportunity to score?
I think, Benoit, the actions of blue has prevented the red player from the opportunity to catch the ball.
Okay. So, and if there is a possibility to try and to try an opportunity to try scoring, so there is a yellow card against 15 blue and penalty try.
Oh, this is very interesting. Wales are going to go in at half-time in front, maybe.
Prevented from catching the ball. However, I'm not absolutely certain that a probable try would have been scored.
Okay.
Had it not been for the actions of blue 15 because of the depth of the kick.
Okay, so we stay in the penalty kick against Italy and yellow card for the 15.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Okay,
so I thought for a moment it was going to be a yellow on a penalty try.
Okay.
As far as I know, let's listen up. It's just
situation.
Going to be a penalty and a yellow.
The players don't try to catch the ball, okay? But we are not sure that a try will be scoring, so it's only penalties and yellow card against 15, okay? You have the choice here on here for the penalty kick. 15.
So the try scorer from earlier, Lorenzo Pani, will spend the next 10 minutes in the bin. I suppose half time it'll actually be 20 minutes. But it's Wales that now have the advantage. What a time to get one. As they go short and up the middle, Chunza. Well repelled. Daniel, next to go. Lloyd, happy to leave it. Still getting there and getting closer. Evans, that time. Italians defending like their lives depend on it.
Tackle three blue. No arms, tackle three blue.
Wales, closer and closer. Will they use the backs? Lloyd. Must be over. The captain, is he there? That is some defending. Has Hawkins got there? Oh my goodness, that is close. There's a knock on spotted.
15, keep going.
Ricardo Genovese penalised, no arms tackle.
Keep going.
Here.
No, the other way, go towards, but inside
Wales
the 15.
Pick and go tactic. Chunza is the man at the heart of it, and he goes again. The power and the drive, and what a try from Chunza. The Exeter chief showing his class. Route one, and he was never going to be stopped. Gigantic man gets over the line. But it was all power and all strength.
Try is good, Benny.
He was taking the whole Italian pack on. Three of them, four of them, falling at his knees.
Yeah,
Wales at half time will go in front. But the enormity of the carry was class. And Chris Chunza. so the extras from the Osprey. Very good this time from Joe Hawkins. Wales going in at half time, their tails very much up. They want to make this final next week against South Africa. They have the edge at the moment after a slow start. Turned out to be a very good half of rugby, particularly for Baron Haywood and his team. We will be back for more action just shortly, but it's Wales under 20s that lead the way. 20 points to 15 here in Treviso. Second half coming up shortly. Well, welcome back to the Stadio Manigo and Treviso. It's Wales just before half time took the lead 20 points to 15 heading into the second half. It's the 21st meeting between the two sides. Wales winning 17, Italy just the 3. So see how this one ends up. Plenty of rugby left. It was a pretty interesting first half. Santi finds Chunza, a try score. He's already shrugging bodies off him. And Cuminetti at par in the second row again. And Wales stretching it early on through Grady. What a powerful outside centre is Mason Grady. And he's back up. It's bigger than George North is Grady. He certainly showed it there. It turns out half as good as George North. He'll be doing quite well, I would suggest. Just when Wales run the front foot, just a bit of a forward pass. Look at Grady, straight over Santi.
Do you remember what I say?
It's just a forward pass to David Jenkins. 20-year-old Grady plays at Cardiff in his debut in the ERC and Zebra. Earlier this season, 6'5", 17 stone. Brother is Corey Allen, course capped by Wales. Former Cardiff horse race player. Recently with the Dragons, he's been unlucky with injuries. Plenty of talent in that family. His mother, Julie, played basketball in the Commonwealth Games for Wales. All the talent of the day. Grady signed his first pro deal with Cardiff at the age of just 18. The problematic area of the scrum continues. See what the Italian fans think. Plenty of whistling going on. They certainly want a quick game. We did get a bit of that towards the end of that second half. Four tries, can't knock that. So many tries in this under 20 summer series. Brilliant to watch. Last night we got 10 in Ireland, England. Georgia beating Scotland as well earlier in Pool B. Plenty going on there. As the kicks come through, Nkogi, Cameron Winnett, and then Kaiserly sticks the boot out. And then he gets back to good proceedings. It's a fine kick. Santi somehow kept his eye on that, rather nonchalantly picked it up. As Wales go through the middle.
Clear up from the kick, Benny.
Carry from Ben Williams on his first start. As Edwards looks for green grass as Ollie Andrew chases. But May goes an amazing run. There's Carlo May. And this boy is rapid. Recently just signed for Clermont Auvergne. As you can see, John O'Gibbs. He's got his eye on Francois May. What a big step in his career. Moving from Rugby Colerno to the Clermont Academy. And finishing fifth in the top 10 league. Maybe getting a shot at the top 14 next season.
I want a long band.
Plenty of competition, but even just being in that environment at Clermont, you'll grow so much. Of course, Paolo Borbisi, Montpellier, so plenty of Italian players playing in France. Even Sebastian Baratta, who's on the bench. Currently, he's at Toulon. Yep. Giovanni Santi, the 10, just moved to Montpellier as well to join Paolo Gorbisi. Such a real area where these Italian players like to go and play some pretty impressive rugby. There is Santi outside of the boot. Asks for a few chasers. Passarella, he's not going to get there.
Leave the leg.
Number one.
So there's a bit of leg lifting from Reece Barrett. Lee will put Wales under the cosh again. Lorenzo Pani has another couple of minutes to wait. As Francois May takes over the kicking duties. One left footer for another. So, first chance of the half goes away. Massimo Brunello and his team, I'm sure a few stern words were given by the coach. Well taken by Matalo. Referee's right arm goes to the sky as they have the advantage. Kugi picks up the scraps. Passarella, so dangerous. Santi cuts himself back inside to his half-back partner, Nkoji. Shendizi needs a bit of support. Matteo acts at 9. Passarella with flashy boots. Nkoji. Rizzoli. Wave after wave of Italian attack. Shendizi gets the helpers in nice and tight. Nkoji swings it the short side, and Santi, the cutout ball to Cuminetti. What a tackle that is by Ollie Andrew. He's earning his stripes in defence, is Ollie Andrew. What a superb work from the white winger. Santi, quick brain, quick thinking. Cuminetti, destined to score. But that is textbook. And the Dragons man got low. Really worked hard to cover the ground and make the big hit.
Okay. Time off. I don't know.
Wales coming into this match beating Scotland 45 points to 15. 7 tries, then beating Georgia 30 points to 24, trailing at half time. Byron Harewood speaking how big a win that was for the team. 11 tries in total.
I don't know.
Ollie Andrew getting a couple in the first game. See how good he is defensively as well. As for Italy, they beat Georgia 36 points to 19. And then they beat Scotland 34-14. Tries galore as well in those two games. It's a bit tighter this evening. As Frangini has another opportunity. And Ortambini, the captain, takes it, but he is smashed. And that's a big win for Wales. He went early at that line out and picked the Italian's pocket. Edwards gets it away. Oh, that's brilliant. What an exit from Dan Edwards, but he'll be turning round to his front eight and saying, well done boys. There are big moments in games like these. As we see another return for Adam Williams, Nathan Evans may be coming from the pitch this time for good. So it's been an eventful 50 minutes for Nathan Evans. Gwent Dragons player got it tight early on with that yellow card in the scrum. And then he got over the line and proved his worth. Really knuckled down. Probably slightly frustrated, but he'll be back.
It's good. Let's go.
Orton Beanie goes off the top. And Sante. Ball in behind, but it's loose. And it's dropped by May. The execution was lacking that time. Ultimately, Lloyd knows a quick option is a good option. And here's Ben Williams. What a rise he's had to get to where he is now. Kick comes through from Winnett. Pani, he's back on the pitch. And puts an absolute bazooka of a boot into the far touchline here for Wales. Just puts pressure back on the red shirts. Santi. Ball behind May. He couldn't do much about it. Ben Williams coming in, picking up the pieces. Bavarian, an Ospreys Academy man. Aberdeen's full debut. And then Ospreys Senior Academy got his contract recently with Aberdeen. Didn't come through any of the systems, the under-18s or under-16s pathway. So a proud moment for him getting his first start. Just shows there's a route for everyone if you're good enough. Here's Italy and May. They are dangerous in attack. Cuminetti is thundered down to the ground. But the power comes through. And the momentum is very much with Italy at the moment. Slowed up. Rizzoli pumps the legs. Does Luca Rizzoli. Again, no scrum half. An opportunistically Wales try. But here is Coogee's back up. Ball has gone forward. Maybe a chance for Wales. Still going. Is Harry Houston. Can he get back up? Yes, he can. He's crying out for a penalty. Bit of seesaw action here. Next try so crucial as well. It wasn't a great ball from Cameron Winnett. He knows the scratch of the head. Because Dan Edwards had looked up and he was going to kick another corner. The pass wasn't good enough. So here we go. Morgan Morse, 17-year-old schoolboy, coming on for Wales. What a talent. With the Ospreys. Really has another year waiting for his exams at the moment. They have tipped him for big things. Scored a try. Against Georgia. He's the youngest player in the squad by a good bit. I'm really looking forward to seeing how he goes. What the future holds for Morgan Morse. Always played a year up at school in the Denver Shield. And the School's Cup. Well, School's Cup recently as well. It's been quite a couple of months for him.
I tell you.
But just like earlier, the referee's had enough. And this time he brands two yellow cards. So all evening the scrum hasn't been settled. And Reece Barrett pays the consequence this time. For this Welsh side. And the same goes for Ricardo Genovese. Picks up the water. Gets a well-earned break, but it's not the break he wanted. So he has 10 minutes. Have a good think about his actions. far side. It's been troublesome. It really is the dark arts. Off the side of rugby, so technical.
Number 8, blue please. Substitution.
Matteo Rubinetto. He's brought off. And Valero Basotto. The rugby Bassano man.
20.
Come on to do his best. And Cameron Jones. He's the next man up. Another Osprey, born in Swansea. Okay.
Don't close the gate.
Massimo Brunarella has really changed things round with this Italian under 20 side. Of course, was capped himself for Italy. His international debut against Ireland in 1988. 8 caps. And then it's a big stalwart at Rovigo. Coached them as well. Also coached at Calvisano. And this is second spell with the Italian, involved with the Italian national team. It's been with the under 20 since 2019. He's doing quite the job. He won't be impressed by that kick from Lorenzo Pani. And Wales go quickly. I'm not sure that was the right option. This is back with the visitors. Italian visitors, I should say. And this time it's better from Pani. As Winnett watches that very closely. Now, thought for a moment he was going to go. There's a safe option, and what a touch that is from Francois May. And Santi weaves and jinks. To tell you who he meets, Chunza. He puts him back in his box. Does the extra second row. Pani looks up and spreads it to Cuminetti. All to play for very much. The stretching, Matalo couldn't do anything about that. It's Morgan Lloyd. Takes that extra step. It's good work from the nine. Pani evades the first tackler. Fractal. Again, a good seven. Trying to get right in there. And he hits it again. Like a bus. Bit of a scrap going on here while the play goes. Wales just need to stay on their guard here. They could be in trouble. They are indeed. It's all very scrappy as Passarella takes up the middle. But Wales must be close to a turnover, and they are. You can see the work on the ground. Really well done. Adam Williams, I think it may have been. Maybe even Ollie Burrows. Replacement hooker. It was one of the front row men that have come on. It was a very good steal.
There is a scuffle between the number 7, red, and 2 blue. Please keep calm and play.
It's getting heated out there. The referee speaks to both captains. Ollie Burrows, another one of the squad from Exeter. Made his debut in the Premiership a against Gloucester back in October, and a few caps in the Premiership Cup. So things going pretty well for a lot of these Welsh under-20s down at Sandy Park. I think just when the referee said it's getting heated, it's going to go for another water break. So warm in Treviso, in the northern parts of Italy, even at this time of night. So hydration is key.
So now he's coming.
So back underway. More Italian substitutes wait. As Edwards goes long again.
Five blue substitution.
Alex Mataloy, the second row, coming off. Francesco Ruffalo. Rugby Colerno player just north of Palma, coming on for the last 25 minutes or so. As Burrows looks up and finds his dart, pulled back. Lovely play from Wales, great line, ever so close now. Our Byron Haywood side, can they get in the corner? Ollie Andrew just stopped. Chunza goes again. He wants a second. Composure needed. But look at that from Italy. They go through the heart and the juggernaut of the Welsh breakdown. But they do so well. And then that last wee error comes. And Wales will have the put in. So trying to turn the screw. A good battle all night. And Cuminetti and Andrew. So this all new front row. For Wales and Burrows, Jones and Adam Williams. Know how important this scrum is. A few anxious looks from Francois May. What will Wales do? Will Woodman look and go himself? No, they go the backs, but Lloyd can't get it away. The ball squirts out as Edwards is hit by three Italian bodies. Lloyd's back up and in amongst it. He looks for a teammate, and Chunza is that man. A bit flat-footed. Does well. The line comes in the end from Cameron Jones. But it's a neck roll. And the crowd gathers a bit of momentum. It just seems as soon as one team gets a penalty, after a couple of phases, the other does as well. It's from 2015. We've got of 20 minutes now. And very, very tense in Treviso.
Benny, just to confirm the penalties.
For tonight, Italy have won their last four matches. Pretty good. Some of their previous 10, they've just won two. Three of those four wins have come by margin of 14 or above points. I'd highly suggest if they win tonight, it won't be by that. Just shows caliber of player and scores they have. Montpellier by Sante. Was his duty. Gets it into Rosette. Frangini. And the captain again. Orton Bennett. Work well. Passarella. Fuji. And Sante. That pass wasn't the right option. And Wales are in there like a thief in the night. Get the turnover. Good digging from the replacement number 9, Luke Davies. Plays for the Scarlets. Does Luke Davies. It's a good kick from him. As Panini collides. Crowd want more than that for Lorenzo Pani. Not going to get it. Well taken from Aston Hopkins. And this time, again, at the breakdown, Wales are penalised. Plenty of numbers for Italy there. And they just smash the first point of contact. The referee has no other option. Gives them a penalty. Neck and neck, even in territory. At least shaded by a couple of percent. Hasn't been much. Pani always looking to go deep. To 10 metres out from the Welsh try line. It's cries of Italia around Treviso. Well taken by Chendisi. This rumbling maul. A potent weapon is trying to get going. They're taking their time. Wales doing ever so well. And they have to use the wide men. Pani, good shooting the line from Hopkins. But Italy get through it. Through Cuminetti. As Grady flies in. And that is a big, big interception from Ollie Burrows. If he hadn't have made that, I think Wales could well have been under their own post. The hooker was there in a vital moment, right on the post of the ruck, and intercepted. It's Federico Cuminetti with the sidestep. And then it's actually Cucci. Got a bit of white line fever. He just couldn't bring the ball with him. It's Carlos Berlise. It's a big reception. One of the local heroes here. He plays at Ruggers Tisvarium. Club very close to here in Treviso. Born in the Dominican Republic. Came off the bench. in the opening games, also involved in the Six Nations earlier this year. Been about the squad for a while. That's Carlos Berlise.
Let's go, it's good. Crash. Bye.
So, a great attacking platform, an area of the pitch for the Italians to prove their worth, and they keep it in tight. And they're still going as they pick and go on the line. Comes, are they over? They're so, so close. Here they go, one more. Bodies everywhere. Still short. Big moments in this match. Just shedding. But as soon as they try and get a bit of composure, the ball goes loose. Cucci breaks himself. Santi weaving, chucking it wide. Cuminetti, he's itching for a score. Has played ever so well. Cucci goes. Back row. And Chendisi just about holds on to it. Well, they slow it up on Rizzoli. Pumps the legs. Another effort. Amortem Pina. Uji opens up. So, so close. Some defending from Wales. Italian have numbers. The cut inside. Oh my goodness. How have they not scored? Some effort from Wales. Cucci smash back. Santi tries. Where is that ball? It's an absolute mess. But Wales, to their credit, are hanging in there. Can they go again? As Italia cries around Stadio Manigo. Pani looks for the wide option. Probably not his greatest one. And somehow Wales hang on for dear life. That is unbelievable. What a proud effort in defence to each one of their men.
Number five.
Two penalty near the goal line. In front of your discipline, okay? Number five, offside.
Ready, I have a check.
David Jenkins penalised. They are going to check something. But phase after phase, they repelled this Italian team.
I'm going to show you a potential deliberate knock on by the red player. I think it's number 12.
Okay,
was there a deliberate knock on? By the Welsh captain, Joe Hawkins. The TMO coming in once again. Let's see. It was Santi.
Okay, I'll put it on the small screen for you now. Watch the
delivers the pass.
Red player, please.
What has Joe Hawkins done here? There were a few Welsh men, I think, maybe going to make the cover tackle. That's up to the referee and the TMO.
Can you show me? The 12 red, try to catch the ball with two hands.
Okay, no problem.
It's just a knock-on for me.
Okay.
So it looks like Joe Hawkins made a deliberate attempt to catch that. So it's just going to be a knock-on. So we'll survive. We will, of course, be still up against it because Italy do, I think, have a penalty.
We just want to check a potential deliberate knock-on. For me, it's not a deliberate knock-on because he has two hands to cut the ball. Okay? So you stay here.
Yeah, that's fine. Joe Hawkins, or leave, man. Very casually said, no problem, referee, that's fine. Better outcome for him than what he maybe thought. Still and back under the post with his defensive duties. As Italy, through their main pack, pick the scrum option. So Italy looking their only fourth win against Wales at this level ever. They need to score soon if that is to happen. Coogee pretty much feeds it into the second row's feet. Referee tells the back row to use it. Shandizi slips over. Ruffalo. Or Tempina. Stopped by the red wall. Marini there, but he doesn't take it. Frangini does. And the power comes once more. These are hard yards. And the advantage, Rizzoli looks to be the next man up, pushes and drives. No try, says the referee, but another penalty. How many more? Not many, as he says. We're going to have another yellow card. So Wales back to 14. And really under the pump. As I hear the words of scrum.
Time off. Substitution.
Replacements are going to have to be brought on. As Adam Williams, the original substitute, is punished. Spent pretty much the rest of this match on the sidelines. He may get a couple of minutes at the end. It's Dan Edwards. He's sacrificed. So 15 against 14. Prize at stake. Fixture in the playoff final against South Africa next Tuesday night. The loser, the playoff in the second place battle as well. Cameron Jones on, and Morgan Morse is brought off. Slavio Pekavicari, Filippo Larunditi. Still wait for their opportunity. Two Italian substitutes. 19 penalties conceded in total. I'd be guessing, must be 7 or 8 at the scrum alone. Certainly a high number. Andrea Poggi does get it in. Told to use it by the referee. Still told to use it. Interestingly, he's going to get another opportunity. They're told to use it. Surely that is your chance.
Keep straight.
suppose they were slightly going forward.
Does
he get another shot, this Italian pack? So the two best teams in Pool B going neck and neck into the last 10 minutes. We're about to approach one score game at the minute, as it sets. Wales do well initially. This time Kogi has to use it, and Santi, and Italy must be in now. Yes, they are. And they're back to a level scoring game. Federico Cuminetti getting the crucial score. A winger of his quality was always going to finish that. Can't say it wasn't coming, especially with the extra man. Santi just picked his time and his moment and told the right winger to do what he does best. He loves a try, this Cuminetti. Did well, used his feet and dived to the ground. He gets plenty of plaudits from his teammates. So, Giovanni Santi with the big conversion from the touchline. Hit the post earlier with one. Is that swinging in? No, it isn't. So, can't separate the sides. 20 points all. What a finish we have. Santi just stretches those hamstrings. He was the orchestrator here. Over the top. Cuminetti stepped inside. He did exactly what he had to do. Smart, the white boots, and the winger's over. A couple of tries already in the summer series, Cuminetti, and he's adding to his tally.
Big finish, bring it home now.
As I think I see Santi come from the pitch, so Niccolo Tanganetti will be the replacement number 10.
Nine.
Sebastian Barata will get his chance as well, the Toulon man. Born in Ferrara, north of Bologna. He's with Treviso under 18s and Italy under 18s in the past. 16 Italian title with Benetton, so he can play. Sebastino Bartara. Good chasing from Morgan Morse. It's Tangini. It's his first kick away. He's for Valorora Rugby. and Santi often exchange at 10. Share this sort of 10 jersey at under 20 level. Both very talented footballers. It's Joe Westwood. Looks on. So, not straight. In Italy. We'll get the scrum. So Westwood will come onto the pitch. Dragons, another Abby Veilman. So nothing between the two sides. This crucial, crucial game. Curry is on the wing for try score Minetti. It's Lorenzo Pani opens up that wiper kick, gets it in. Two touch, 5 minutes to go. We're just saying, did they carry it back in? The answer is no. So, Wales need something. They need it quick. And they have the advantage. Chunza was brought down at the line out. Luke Davis does get it away as the kick comes across. Picked up. But he hasn't brought the ball with him. Has Mason Grady. As Marini is penalised for bringing Chunza down. So interesting call here. What will we see? 5 points to go. Joe Hawkins. Surely it's a shot to nothing and worth the effort. Quite long way out. You'd expect him to have the range. Last night's game was won by a Sam Prendergast kick at goal. It was a wee bit later on, 15. A wee bit further out. But Joe Hawkins could be the hero. Can the skipper put Wales in front? Give them a 3-point buffer. Hawkins has one last look. Strikes it high into Treviso sky. And how good is that from Joe Hawkins? It never looked anywhere else. And he shows his class, the inside centre. 23 points to 20, Wales lead. And they've got to hang on at the moment. They'll be heading into the playoff final against South Africa. Still all to play for. He's back, I thought, with an Italy shirt, but then Chinunza picks it up, but then he makes the spill. So both errors coming. He hasn't made many today, has Chinunza. And Crowder getting rattled. But Wales won't be caring. They've got 3.5 minutes to hold on. So Adam Williams serves his punishment. Wales are back up to 15. A few worried looks on this Italian bench. They'll be heartbroken if they can't get over the line tonight in this inaugural summer series. They'll still be hoping they can pull a rabbit out of the hat. Just when it's going your way, the decisions also go your way. As they have a free kick. Stan Edwards, of course, is back on as well. Pani, it's now or never for Lorenzo Pani. Wales shut him down. Basotto, he's very dynamic, the big man. Batara, he says there's enough time for his cavalry to chase. That's too eager. Vicari. There it comes. Wales will have an advantage and a penalty as Ollie Andrew looks for it. He doesn't chase in the end. And we will come back. These are precious moments for Wales, holding on. Oh, this would be a dogged win.
Towards the sideline. Yeah, and towards the
halfway. Byron Haywood and his team.
Towards the halfway.
They'll be delighted.
Towards the halfway.
Particularly after a tricky enough Six Nations campaign, finishing fifth with only one win, beating Scotland. But that was all. Change of fortunes in this series. And they're certainly taking their time for this one. So they should. I'm very surprised if this went anywhere near the backs. Burrows. Jenkins takes it and he asks his teammates to latch on. And what a decision the referee has given. He's got the arm out. Must be an advantage, and it is. And that'll be that for Wales. Chinunza, he still goes on. He's been arguably the best player on the pitch. As the ball spilled, but they won't care. Luca Rizzoli, the man penalised, and we're in the red. Surely that is that. As the ball is sent into the stands, and you can see what it means to Wales. They're absolutely delighted. They want to win this series. It'll be a big, big ask against South Africa next Tuesday evening, but they've won Pool B, and their skipper, Joe Hawkins, was the hero of the night with that penalty on the 76th minute. What a game we've had in Treviso. But the Italians that are absolutely heartbroken, and it's Wales and Byron Haywood and his team that go through into the playoff final. Full time here in Treviso. Wales win 23 points to 20.